Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about what are the different kinds of or what are the different types of colloidal system, and in which basically we have got to know about the soles also. And in this case basically the soles are nothing but a formation of a solution where a dispersed phase is of solid phase that could be easily dispersed in a medium that could be either a liquid phase or that could be either a gaseous phase. So therefore that are been called as soles. And now the soles are basically divided into two types, that is basically lyophilic soles as well as lyophobic soles. So what are these two terms and what are the difference between these two terms? Let us talk about this in this lecture. So as the name says that philic means the one which is attraction and the phobic which means that is fear or repulsion, if you could say that better. So now let us understand the definition of it first and what are these two terms. Let us talk about that one. So talking about the first one, that is there is strong affinity between the dispersed phase and the dispersion medium, because soul is basically a part of a system where we are talking about the colloidal, that is, so soul is basically a part of a system that is basically known as colloidal dispersion, and in that case basically dispersion medium and dispersion phase, these are the two interactive things so as to make a colloidal dispersion. So in this case basically there is a strong affinity of the dispersed medium along with that of the dispersed phase, so they have a very strong affinity towards each other. By talking about the lyophobic soles, so there is less affinity between the dispersed phase and the dispersed medium. So these are the two terms that we should understand in with the help of a definition. So now let us understand the next point which would differentiate between the lyophobic soles as well as lyophilic soles. So let us understand that one. So talking about the second point, that is the viscosity of the sole is higher than that of the dispersion medium. So let me talk about this one. So this is the point which is related to that is lyophilic soles. So as I have said earlier also, that is the affinity of the dispersed medium along with that of towards that is the dispersed phase, it is more, and that's the reason that the viscosity of the sole that has been formed is very much higher than compared to that of the dispersion medium. So that is what the viscosity is basically higher, and which is because of the attraction or because of the affinity of the two that is contents of the colloidal dispersion, that is dispersion phase as well as dispersion medium. While talking about the lyophobic, soles, so the viscosity of the sole is the same as that of the dispersion medium. So yes, because they are basically more separated from each other because of their nature, that they are have less affinity. So here the viscosity that doesn't increase as but maybe it will remain the same, because there is no kind of aggregation that we could say, or no kind of that is affinity towards each other. So that's the reason that viscosity will be same. And let's talk about the next point, and that is, so the surface tension is basically lower for the sole compared to that of the dispersion medium. But as we know that dispersion medium is a continuous phase, so it will be throughout the whole solution or throughout the whole colloidal solution. And we're talking about the sole, which is basically made up of the dispersed phase, and that will have basically which is solid in nature. So that solid sole or that dispersed phase will have basically a lower surface tension compared to that of the dispersion medium. But we are talking about this one, that is the system or the name of the system. So that is same as that of the dispersion medium when we are talking about the lyophobic soles. So these are the two differences I have talked about, and now let us understand the next difference. That is, much larger amount of electrolytes are required for the coagulation of the sole particles. Much more larger amount of the electrolytes are being required. So this is what we are going to talk about in the future lecture also. But let me talk about the electrolytes. Electrolytes are the one which have basically partially positive charge or partially negative charge. Whenever they get dissociate so as to form ions, so they have completely positive charge as well as they have completely negative charge. So this charged particles allow the other particles so as to coagulate. So as because the charged particle obviously they will attract the other opposite charge particles towards itself, and that's the reason that coagulation happens. So in this case basically more amount of electrolytes are being required so as the sole would get coagulated with each other. But meanwhile here a small amount of an electrolyte is very much fine so as to coagulate the sole particles. So these are the two differences between these two then. And talking about the next one, that is they are highly stable in nature, and while they are less stable in nature when we are talking about lyophilic soles as well as lyophobic soles. So this is where the difference between these two. So this were the two difference, or this is the difference between these two terms, and that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and the more information that you could get in our next section also. So till then, please don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel and please share this video with your friends. Thank you.